Episode before the season finale. I decided not to do Batman Arkham Asylum. I'm still there for season two. What game are we reviewing?
Yeah, I wonder. We are reviewing the biggest disaster ever. What's it called again? Darks the Days.
It's like playing through a history textbook.
I don't mind that. You get to kill a whole bunch of stuff. But we got it to the PC, and it sucks. It freezes all the time, no matter what computer you use it on. I mean, I got it to work really well once on our laptop with a wireless mouse. Mm-hmm. But with the wired, no. It doesn't work on a regular computer either. Yeah, it's basically a piece of crap. I haven't played it on the Xbox, and he wants it on the Xbox to see what it's like.
Hey, I just want to say something. The reviews to this game, they don't show them except for this one. It says, Darkest of Days just moved up on my most wanted list for 2009. DLD is set to be an epic first-person shooter that travels across space and time. So this review was before the game even came out.
Who the hell is PC Guru?
Some online guy. Says take a journey in time to some of the bloodiest days in human history.
Wage battle against hundreds of enemies on screen at once with historically accurate and futuristic weapons in an effort to preserve history as it was meant to be. Futuristic weapons, my ass.
I think his name is Alex Morris, and you get whisk away from Custer's Last Stand to a place called Chronotech, and they send you through time to save certain people and overall save the guy who found Chronotech. And it's kind of weird that the guy that they whisked away to Chronotech has no voice, and he doesn't even question what he's being asked to do.
Well, he has no voice because he got shot in the balls with an arrow.
Well, he doesn't even question what he's doing. He just does it.
Well, if I got to kill people, I wouldn't.
The game was made by 8 Monkey Labs. This is the only game they've ever made. It's the first game. The big rise to fame with this game is that there's more people on screen than ever before, but the AI is horrible.
And it's rated mature for blood, violence, and strong language. No dare. The other guy that's supposed to be your friend or whatever, he cusses up a storm. I mean, more than any other person. Sometimes he doesn't use curse words right, he just says them. I don't like it.
Yeah, no. Overall rating, I give it a -1 out of 5. What do you think?
I give the temperature.
21 degrees.
No. Oh! Okay, the windshield temperature is -9.
Oh. Okay. It's getting freezing cold out, huh?
Yeah,
so, basically what we're saying, this game is a piece of shit, and you should stay away. In fact, I can't even find it in stores.
I'll be uploading my winter videos soon. It's got, like, backyard, front yard, and we went to the magical castle.
Well, thanks for watching. This game is a piece of shit. And tune in next time for the season finale, where we review Saw the Final Chapter or Saw 3D.
Yeah, we already filmed that.
Yes, we did, but we're going to upload it after this.
No, we're going to upload it, but you said we're going to upload it at the same time. Okay. Alright. Goodbye. And be looking for my show. It's either going to be Angry Jew or The Jew Nerd.